perform the mitzvah. While they may not refer to it by that name, they can still perform an act of kindness for another person. Kindness has a place in every religion. When we perform acts of kindness, we are living our faith. In thinking about the idea of performing mitzvahs, I have been thinking about how people perform mitzvahs without even knowing it. By living our lives, by just being ourselves, we may be helping others. I am a member of the United Methodist Women. Each year, we go on a retreat out to Camp Winnipeg to help clean up the camp and prepare it for the upcoming summer camp season. You may be thinking that the services those 10 or so women perform at the camp, the painting, the gardening, the window washing, that those services are the mitzvahs, but that is not so. A mitzvah is a selfless act. The work we do out at Winnipeg is not selfless. We receive much by doing that service. We receive fellowship, food, and a reduced cabin rate for giving our time to the camp. But I will tell you of one mitzvah which was done this year from the camp. I was down in Florida at the time of the retreat, and was so depressed that I was going to miss it. The retreat was literally a week before my mom passed away, and it was simply a horrible time for me. My fellow UMW members, the ladies who were heading out to Winnipeg, knew this, and they knew how very much the retreat means to me, and they wished that I was there with them. So they decided to bring me along. They downloaded photos of me in various outfits and poses from Facebook, mounted them on foam board, and carried me along everywhere I went. On the Monday following the retreat, I signed on to Facebook from my mom's house and found an entire photo album of pictures entitled Janet at Camp Winnipeg. Okay, let's see if I can do this right. On the ferry ride from Greenport, I was there in the car. At the Shelter Island golf course, I was in the cart on the tee box, and sadly, I was also in the sand trap. At Sweet Tomatoes Restaurant, there I was between a basket of bread and a glass of red wine. And at Willard One Bunkhouse at Winnipeg, I was in the kitchen, playing board games, and having a cup of coffee. The comments that were posted under each picture relayed to me the love and care and support my friends shared with me. They were hysterically funny, and I laughed until I cried. What a gift. What a mitzvah. Those ladies had no idea what they had given to me. Sure, they had a good time laughing and planning each photo, but the joy and love that they'd given me was beyond their imagining. In my position here as lay leader, I have sat in on many, many meetings over the past almost 3 years. At many of those meetings, I have heard many committee chairs express the desire for new committee members and more participation from the people of our church. We here at